Joel Osei, who's 26 years old, killed a 43-year-old Irishman, Adrian Murphy.
Rudy Guede, murder of British student Meredith Kircher.
Callum Farquhar, Rakeem Leandri and Jordan Parker were found guilty of murdering Christopher Albury Burridge.
16 strangers from all walks of life are on their way to this iconic London tower.
I have never had power. This is my turn to take control.
To battle for power
and compete to win up to £100,000.
I hate losing. Winning is the only option.
Some will live a life of luxury at the top, whilst others will live a life of hard work at the bottom.
Lift falling.
But unlike the real world, here, anyone can become powerful.
You've got to have that killer instinct.
They just need to convince their rivals that they've got what it takes to lead.
Lift rising.
And once in power, how long will they be able to stay there? Only the person who rises above all the rest will take home the cash prize.
I am very manipulative when I want to be. I know how to make people fall in love with me. And in the end, they're going to trust me so much that they're going to start doubting themselves.
Fake it till you make it. Confidence is key.
I'm not here to make friends.
When you've got a face like this, you've got to get it at the front. There's no point being at the back, is there?
I can't be a follower.
Strategy and alliances are everything.
$250,000 reward was offered for his arrest. Sean Laval Smith, the suspect in the stabbing death of Brianna Kupfer.
21-year-old Sean Bull murder. 24-year-old Paulius Petrosawanis.
21 years old Aloisi Dada admitted stabbing the 17-year-old Katrina Makanova to death.
Zephaniah McLeod admits killing uni worker Jacob Billington, aged 23.
Ali Harbi Ali, his arrest at the scene of the murder of MP Sir David Amos.
Marianne Lenigan's body was discovered in a park in Reading. Officers believe the girls got into a maroon car with a group of men.
Garika Gordon was arrested on suspicion of murder. The body was identified as Phoenix Nets.
Michael Adebolajo and Michael Adebowale, they ran over Fusilier Lee Rigby, armed with knives and a meat cleaver. Adebolajo tried to behead him. Adebowale hacked at his body.
Sven Sinonga Kui were found guilty of Jodie's murder. Just a few months before she died, Jodie had visited 10 Downing Street with her scout group.